الله الرحمن الرحيم. بشكر حضراتكم جميعا وندخل في الموضوع عشان الوقت ضيق قوي. Female patient 58 years old, housewife, Egyptian, non diabetic and hypertensive and chronic asthmatic, brought to the ED in Mbaba Fever Hospital by ambulance in a deep coma state. The patient was quite well until one day before admission when she complained of headache, fever, and vomiting, for which she received non-specific medications from a private dispensary. The patient did not improve. Rather, she has also been noticed to be confused for hours before losing her conscious level. The relatives denied any history of trauma, seizures, weakness, or loss of motor or sensory power. The patient, past history over the last 5 years, the patient admitted in our hospital with two similar episodes over 2 weeks with a history suggestive of meningitis at 2010 and 2012. There is a history of unilateral rhinorrhea and the feeling of salty fluid in her throat. No history of head trauma or nasal operation. There is a remote history of hysterectomy 35 years ago. On examination, the patient was morbid obese with flat decubitus, deeply comatose, GCS, severe, 7 over 15, E2M4V1. Globules round, regular, active, no jaundice, no neck veins, neck veins not congested, mild beating edema in her lower limbs. She was vitally stable, temperature 37.5, pulse 90 per minute, blood pressure normal, respiratory rate 22, normal oxygen saturation, tongue moist with no injury, and no evidence of previous convulsions. Chest normal, vesicular breathing with occasional expiratory sounds, expiratory lumpy. A cardiovascular examination, unremarkable. Abdomen, soft liver, and spleen was not palpated, and no lymphadenopathy. Joint examination was normal. Neurological examination, there was no signs of lateralization, no signs of cranial nerve affection, and the neck was rigid with clinic and the Bosinus curios positive. Investigations, lab investigations, random blood sugar was high, 345, creatinine normal, creatinine normal, liver enzymes normal, alkaline phosphatase normal, bilirubin also was normal, and normal serum electrolytes. CBC revealed absolute neutrophilia and leukocytosis. Leukocytic count was neutrophils 88%, neutrophils count, white disease count was 16,000. CSF analysis, whitish prevalent with big protein clot, cell count more than 5,000 per cubic millimeter, neutrophils 95%, lymphocytes 5%. Gram stain revealed gram positive diplococcus capsulated streptococcus pneumoniae. Sugar in CSF 133 milligram per dl, protein 292 high. CSF culture aerobic culture revealed the growth of streptococcus pneumoniae sensitive to penicillin, vancomycin, and cefepirazole. Non-contrast CT scan of the paranasal sinuses revealed a small bony defect at the right aspect of the floor of the anterior cranial fossa, associated with cystic-like opacification of the right sigmoidal air cells, mild right maxillary sinusitis. And this is a CT, and you can see the bone defect in the sinus. Okay, the arrows, also here. Okay. The patient immediately received on admission at ED the first dose of dexamethasone, 15 milligram per kg per dose, then continued over the next 4 days. Vancomycin and ceftriaxone was initiated, started as empirical treatment, then replaced ceftriaxone by ciforadenant after the result of culture and sensitivity. Mannitol and dehydrating measures was given for the first 2 days and support, together with supportive treatment. After 2 days, the patient regained consciousness became afebrile and discharged after 2 weeks without any neurological sequelae and referred to neurosurgical for neurosurgical closure of the cranial defect. وفعلا البيشنت دي اتعمل لها العمليه وبعد كده الديفكت ده ما بقتش تجي لها تاني، يعني عملنا لها فولو اب كده كل 6 شهور الحمد لله ما جالهاش منينجاكس بعد كده. Diagnosis recurrent bacterial meningitis. Discussion recurrent meningitis indicate a blood a host defect either in the local anatomy or in the antibacterial antibacterial and immunologic defenses. Streptococcus pneumoniae is by far the most frequent cause of recurrent meningitis. History of hip trauma is much more frequent in patients with recurrent meningitis. ودي مهمة قوي ان احنا الزملاء اللي بيشتغلوا في الطوارئ لابد عيان المنجايتس even لو the first attack لازم نسأل على history of hip trauma اللي ممكن تكون جات له زمان ودي first attack وهيجيله بعد كده، فعشان كده اقدر اصوره واشوف ان في عنده كرينال ديفكت ولا لا عشان امنع انها تتكرر له تاني. طيب susceptible patients to have pneumococcal meningitis are
those with defects in the drug matter those with defects in the dura mater after head injury or surgery, those with chronic infections.
those with defects in the dura mater after head injury at surgery or surgery, those with chronic infection in the skull, chronic subulative otitis media, sinusitis, patients with large nasal bulb or even after bulbectomy. Individuals who lack spleen, الناس اللي هم عاملين سبلينكتومي اللي شايلين السبلين برضه عرضه ان هم يحصل لهم recurrent infection. After abdominal trauma or after splenectomy for lymphoma or other malignancies. The anatomic defect may produce a CSF leak, rhinorrhea, which may be intermittent. Meningitis may occur months or years after head injury. Conclusion, any patient with bacterial meningitis, particularly if it's recurrent, should be evaluated carefully for any congenital or post-traumatic defect. Closure of the CSS fistula should be carried out to prevent further episodes of meningitis. Persistent rhinorrhea for more than 4 to 6 weeks is an indication for surgical repair. Thank you.